double quick. The same old thing we did last week. Not a thing there is. But sit on the bridge. We're not alright. We're not alright.
Now, boys, I tell you what, Legend outdid himself with these Sloppy Joes this time. Now, they ought to take these right here and put them up at the Appalachian Artisan Center.
Yeah, they are pretty good, bub. Probably some of the best he's made.
Well, hell, they ought to be good after all the stuff they made me go through. Those motherfuckers don't pay me enough for this shit.
Legend, all you do is follow instructions on a box and throw it on a stove.
Well, it takes a hard-working man to make a Sloppy Joe this good, you son of a bitch. Now you think it's so easy? Why don't you come back here and make a dozen of them bitches yourself?
Nah, I'm good, man. I ain't got time for Sloppy Joes when I'm too busy getting sloppy hoes, you feel me?
That's what I thought.
The boys, my pecker just went past my knees. Look what a woman just came in through here.
Oh, yeah, bro. She's a good girl, bro. I've already slept with her, bro. She'll be good for you. I guarantee it, bro.
Nah, Austin, I can believe something like that from old Bruce, but you, boy, I know you ain't done nothing with her.
Yes, I did, bro. How are you just, like, not believing me, bro? Sloppy Joes, sloppy seconds, same thing, bro. It's good for you, bro.
All right, then, McGee. What's her name?
That's Jasmine King, bro. She's one of the baddest chicks around here, dude. Like, bro, she went to GPS, bro. You know, I was saying something about her, bro.
Well, boys, I tell you what, I don't care if she went over to Camp Crystal Lake. Old Bobby's gonna go over and talk to her.
I don't know, Bobby. Maybe you should sit out on this one.
Well, ha! I can't believe you don't believe in me, Brucey.
Don't listen to him, Bobby. The concept of standards don't exist as long as you believe in yourself.
Well, thank you, Gregory. At least someone believes in me. Now, if you boys excuse me, I'm gonna go get me a woman.
Wait, bro. Let me hit first, bro. I gotta make sure she's still good for you, bro.
Oh, well, you know, boys, I thought I seen a beautiful woman over this way. Jasmine, ain't it?
Yeah.
Well, Jasmine, how about I buy you a couple Sloppy Joes and I bring you over to the house and you give me a little low mang, if you know what I mean. Da-da-da-da. Now, you boys think that's funny, but I just don't think that's fair. If I was a little skinny boy like old Bruce or Austin or Legend over here, now I would have had a chance, but where I'm a big fat boy and all, she just wanted to slap me upside my head and get on. Now I just don't think that's right.
Well, Bobby, it'd probably help if you didn't look at every piece of ass that walks in a 5-mile radius of you. It also don't help you coming up here to the big and stiffy stuff in your face full of Sloppy Joes. Buddy, come up to the plex with me and the boys. We're going to get our muscle up. Come with us.
Now, you know what, Brucey? I might just take you up on that offer this time. Now, I'm tired of being a big fat boy. Can't even get no woman. Now, I believe I'm going to go and get my life together and go get in shape with you all.
That's the spirit, bub. Look, if you want something in life, you just got to go for it. You know it ain't going to come easy to you, bro.
Yeah, bro. I heard Chad is up there at the sports books right now. Get a good workout, bro. We should go up there.
I tell you what, boys. I'll meet you over in 10 minutes.
Okay, Bobby. Let me teach you the basics of working out, bub. After that, you'll be an alpha like me.
Well, Chad, I just want to say thank you for going out of your way and showing me how to work out, but I really do appreciate this.
It's no problem, Bobby. You came to the right place, bub. I once had sex with an actress named Megan Fox. Had so much stamina that we did it for about 24 hours. Eventually, I just had to quit because she said I was too much for her. There's no better exercise than that right there, Bobby.
Well, it must be nice having women actually be attracted to you. Well, I guess that's why I'm here, though.
That's the way you gotta look at it, Bobby. Before long, you'll be lifting 1,000 pounds over your head like me. Well, we're wasting time just standing here, bub. Let's go ahead and get started.
Rising up back on the street.
tiger.
Now, Chad, that was just a complete waste of my time. Now, I could have been up at the Big and Stiffy having a conversation with Legend trying to pick up some women, but no. Instead, I decided to come up here to the Sportsplex with y'all trying to work out, and y'all sitting there looking like the new Team Arrow, looking so stout, and me sitting here looking like the Michelin Man.
Bub, don't give up yet, Bobby. Gotta work hard if you want to be an alpha like me.
Now, Bobby, you know he's right. It takes time and effort to see the results you want. You gotta put the work in. It ain't gonna come easy. You know, you really gotta find what motivates you, bub. You gotta stay with it. What's the one thing you want most in life and go for it? Chase it, bub. You know, you just gotta put the work in. Stay with it.
Now, maybe you're right, Brucey. Maybe I just gotta find my true inspiration. Now, let's see. What's the one thing I want most in life? Two sloppy joes with an order of cheese sticks and Mountain Dew?
Now, I knew it wouldn't be long before you come here and make me do my job, you motherfucker. Now, what's a feller got to do to take a break around here? Go take a shit? A shit break? That's all I get?
Now, Legend, I promise you, I got a plan with this, and this time it's just a process. Now, take my money and give me some sloppy joes, boy.
You just lucky I need this job, you ungrateful son of a bitch. It'd be ready about 15 minutes, buddy.
Now, all right, Bobby, it's your time to shine. It's like Brucey said, find the one thing you want most in life and lift it. So that's just what I'm going to do. So let me get over here and grab this Big and Stiffy and we'll start. Ha-da-da. 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 Yep, I'm going to be swole for long, buddy. You just watch. Whew. Now, I'm struggling more than a preacher with a mouthful of peanut butter, buddy. I believe I'm done for the day. But this is just awful. Now I sit here and lifted a box of Big and Stiffy for 2 hours and I still don't look any stronger. Maybe there ain't no point to all this. Maybe I'm just meant to be a big fat boy. Well, can't say I didn't try. Let's just go home, go to bed. Well, Bobby, another day's gone by. Another day you ain't got no woman. Now I just wish for one day I'd wake up and I'd be a big stout man like Chad. But no, I gotta sit here and be a big fat boy. Well, let's go to sleep. We'll see what tomorrow holds. Probably same thing as today. Hey. Alright, Bobby. Another day of being a fat boy. Well, let's try to go over here and look as good as I possibly can. Now, boys, this is a dream come true. I look like Oliver Queen. I guess the old Big and Stiffy grip actually worked. I bet I can go up there and get all kinds of women now. Let's see what old Chad has to say now about being an alpha. Now, I'm telling you, boys, all I did was go up to the Big and Stiffy, ordered me a couple sloppy joes, lifted them for a couple hours, and before you knew it, I woke up big as Legend's truck.
Well, congratulations, Bobby. I always knew you could do it.
Congrats, bro. You look like a total badass right now, bro. If you start getting chicks, remember, bro, let me hit them up first. Sleep with them, bro. I gotta make sure they're good for you, bro. I'll be good to you, bro.
You're officially an alpha now, Bobby. But just remember who the leader of the pack is, bub.
Well, thank you, boys. I really appreciate y'all pushing me to my limits. Well, what y'all say we go ahead and get us a workout started before people start crowding in here? Now, boys, I can already tell difference in my body. That Big and Stiffy grip did wonders for me.
Bub, that's just the start of being an alpha, Bobby. Before long, you'll be sleeping with actresses like me. Maybe you can go for Scarlett Johansson. We'll go on double dates, bub. Tag team.
Chad, buddy, I might just do that, man. This is just the start of my new life.
Excuse me, sir. I couldn't help but notice you look a whole lot more buff than the last time I seen you here at the gym. Your growth has been incredibly fast, and I'm dying to know your secret. How do you get so buff so fast, man?
Well, to tell you the truth, I just went up to the Big and Stiffy and ordered me a couple sloppy joes, and I started lifting them things like weights, and all of a sudden, I just started looking like a brute.
You're kidding. You mean to tell me you got that amazing body from lifting sloppy joes?
Yes, sir. That's my new technique. I call it the Big and Stiffy grip. Guaranteed to make you big and stiffy in one night.
Well, man, let me tell you, that is a really amazing technique that you've discovered. I gotta go tell my buddies about this.
Oh, well, you know, boys, people's actually starting to notice me.
Now, Bobby, you know for sure everybody's going to be up at the Big and Stiffy trying to do that exercise you came up with.
Nah, I'm sure it won't get too out of hand, Brucey. Da-da-da! Now, boys, everyone's using my exercise.
Well, Bobby, what the hell you think, bub? Dear God, you found an exercise that puts 50 pounds of muscle on you in one night. What do you think was going to happen?
You did this to me. Now, I'm going to kill you for making all these customers come in for me to make them sloppy joes, you motherfucker.
Legend! Are all them boxes filled with sloppy joes, boy?
What else would they be filled with? Because of you and your workout, I had to make over 2,000 sloppy joes this morning. Them motherfuckers about to kill me out, buddy.
Legend, I'm sorry, old boy. I just wanted to get in shape. I didn't think it'd go to these extremes.
Well, sorry ain't gonna make these sloppy joes. Well, I guess that ain't your job, though. Let me go ahead and get back to it. Now, I hate my job.
Well, boys, I don't think we're going to be able to sit at the Big and Stiffy this time. We may as well just head out. Hey, look over there. He's here. Stop right there.
What in the world?
Thank God I finally caught you. You're a hard man to find, Mr. Bobby.
Ma'am, do I know you?
Right, where are my manners? Allow me to introduce myself.
My name is Margaret Thacker, anchor and reporter at the Liberal News Station. We heard about your new workout routine and how it became a huge success. We'd really like to be the first to get the scoop on how you came up with such a great idea.
Now hold on just a minute. Are you saying you want to do a news story on me?
That's right, Bobby. One story with me, and the whole world will know about your routine. You'll be a star.
Now, balls, I can't believe this. Now I'm going to be famous.
Congratulations, Bobby. You deserve it, man.
I say, if you ever want to do a story on the next big aspiring rapper, I'm at a fire mixtape called 3P.
Oh, get out of here, you dirty hoodlum.
Anyway, let's start the interview whenever you're ready.
Well, I'm ready when you are, Miss Thacker.
I'm standing here today with a familiar face to many in the Eastern Kentucky area. A Knott County man named Jim Bobby.
You may know him as the creator of the famous workout routine titled The Big and Stiffy Grip.
Mr. Bobby, how did you create such a wonderful workout routine that turned out to be an overnight success?
Well, really, it all started when my buddies inspired me to go to the Knott County Sportsplex to try to work out. But nothing I was doing was quite working for me. So what I decided to do was come up here to the Big and Stiffy, ordered me a couple sloppy joes, and I started lifting them suckers like weights. Next thing you know, I woke up the next morning looking like Henry Cavill.
Well, that is an amazing story, Bobby, and I'm sure many people around the world are in gratitude of you for discovering such an amazing workout. Now back to you, Jim.
Great story, kid. If you have any new scoops, you know where to find me.
Now don't you worry, Miss Thacker. I'll be sure to stay in contact now that I'm famous.
Bobby, you're really soaking all this up, ain't you, bub?
Nah, Brucey, people are finally recognizing me for who I am. I can finally be happy.
Bobby, it's nice you're getting this attention and everything, but be humble. You know, these people don't care about you. They're not giving you attention for who you are. They're giving you attention because you're jacked, and they're exploiting your exercise there, bub.
Now, why is it that when I'm at my lowest point and I'm down and depressed, y'all are perfectly fine with it, but whenever I finally get buff and find happiness, no, you can't do that, Bobby. You gotta go back to being a big fat boy and can't be happy. Well, I'm tired of it. I'm gonna live the life I want to live, and there's nothing nobody can do to stop me.
Bobby, people dedicate their whole lives to getting in shape, and all of a sudden, in one night, you drop 100 pounds of fat and gain 50 pounds of muscle. Don't you think there's a catch to this?
The only thing I'm concerned about is finding me a woman now that I'm rich, famous, and beautiful.
Hey, Bobby.
No, hey there, Jasmine. Well, you come to smack me upside my head again?
Yeah, about that. That was kind of my mistake. But you can understand, right? I mean, it is all in the past.
Well, you put it that way, I guess I kind of can understand where you're coming from. Plus, if you wouldn't have smacked me upside my head, I wouldn't have went worked out and got rich and famous. By the way, I am rich and famous.
Oh my gosh, that is so awesome. So, do you still want to spend your money? I mean, go on that date?
A date? Did you just say a date? Boys, I never thought I'd see the day when my little buddy finally get put to use. If you excuse me, boys, I've got a date to the movies.
Bro, not cool, bro. You're supposed to let me hit it first, bro.
Well, Chad, this is the life, old boy. The life of an alpha. Ain't that right, Scarlet?
Yeah.
You got that right, Bobby. Them other boys never believed in you like I did, bub.
They're not alpha like us, Bub. They couldn't handle any of these beautiful actresses we got, like Megan Fox and Scarlett Johansson, or any of the actresses we could pull, Bub.
Chad, I believe you right, bud. I believe we better off without them boys. And Brucey said something was bound to go wrong. Everything's going perfectly right in my life.
We interrupt this program to bring you important news.
Here we go!
Millions of people across the globe are turning into what can only be described as flesh-eating zombies.
Yes, you heard that right, folks. The world is now undergoing a zombie outbreak.
Oh, girl.
This outbreak all started with a popular workout routine known as the Big and Stiffy Grip. Apparently, the workout is causing people everywhere to lose brain cells, slowly converting them into mindless zombies.
The man responsible for this is none other than Knott County's own Jim Bobby.
Hey.
If you or a loved one are in an open area, please find shelter immediately. And please, make sure to barricade your windows! It's on me! Get it off me! Get it off me! Help!
Well, rip.
Bobby!
Chad!
Help me, Bobby! They're trying to eat me like a pig in a poke rack of ribs.
Chad, don't you worry, bud. Me and you can take them together. Jasmine! Jasmine! Speak to me! Tell me you're gonna be alright!
Bobby, I can't feel my leg.
No, Jasmine, I didn't mean for none of this to happen. Now, I should have listened to Brucey. I was getting in over my head and I didn't even know it. Now, if I knew that getting rich and famous and swole was going to cost me my best friend and the love of my life, I just never would have done it. And I'd rather go back to being the big fat boy that nobody likes than sit here and watch y'all get hurt.
Bobby, don't put yourself down like that. You're such a good guy. I mean, I really just wanted you for your money, but maybe I was wrong. It's your soul that makes you who you are. Now go. Go live, Bobby. Live. Life.
No, Jasmine. Stay with me. No, God. Why? Why is she the one that got hurt for my actions? Why is she the only one that got hurt?
Still need help, Bobby.
Come on, Jasmine. Please get up. Please. I don't want you to die. No. No.
No!
Oh, it must have all just been a dream. Makes me want to appreciate my life for what it actually is. I gotta go get up and start my day.
So I gotta hear it, Bobby. Did I whip the zombies with my bare fist with my amazing sheer force as high chief?
Well, Chad, let's just say things made a lot more sense when I woke up. Made me realize I need to appreciate my life for what it is, whether I'm a fat boy or not.
Even if that means you can't have Jasmine King as your girlfriend?
Yeah, buddy, I figure it's probably better off that way. Besides, I already got a good crew to run around with anyway.
Well, Bobby, I'm glad you learned something from all this, even though none of this actually happened.
Now I learned something too.
Now what's that, Legend?
I learned you motherfuckers need to go home so I can catch a damn break.